Good morning. First of all, to welcome you again, ladies and gentlemen, aquatic family, in this beautiful and very attractive city of Doha, with this excellent, outstanding organization. Of course, we want to thank to the Qatar Swimming Association, Qatar Olympic Committee, Minister of Sport, everybody supporting us, and it's a great opportunity to show the value of our sport. What are the objectives of this convention? You are here today because you are part of Aquatic Family, family which show an impressive success over the last years. Everybody saying FINA is stronger, FINA is important, and FINA now is part of the first group to Olympic sports. And this is because in London, through the research conduct, independent research, it's important to say, conducted by the IOC, we are the first sport with the number of television viewers worldwide. We are the first sport in intervention in internet, and we are the first sport for youth. Youth choose what is the favorite sport for youth, and was aquatics, all the discipline. And this is why it was a great success for us. We have to celebrate this success, of course, and with the new inspiration to continue to grow, to continue to be successful, and to look on the key elements which can lead to the continuing improve of future of the aquatics. We have two good programs today, one for coaches, one for the administrators. In coaches, we bring the best to discuss the latest coaching techniques and new platforms. It's very important, this exchange of information from the people and the coaches. Unfortunately, this time it's only for swimming, but in the future, probably we are going to enlarge to other disciplines. For administrators, the program this year should be successful inside and outside aquatics, helping the aquatics family to reflect internally and most successful areas from the past year, inspiration for the future programs. From all the level, coaching, development, sponsorship, partnership, marketing, hosting events, media, new media, social media, experts will weigh in the what it takes to get success in each of these areas, helping aquatics strive for more success in the future. The conference will provide you with an exciting platform, hearing from international experts, drawing on their real experience, and giving practical tips to gain new insight and inspire visionary thinking can be used in the future. Then we are here together for these two areas of our activity, coaches area and administrator. When we hope with this convention, we will do a pass forward, a step forward, and building in the future the success of aquatic sports. Now, I'm going to touch a point which is probably the most important in our activity, not only for the coaches, but for the administration and federations and everybody implicated in sport. This is the international calendar. Today, everybody knows that the calendar is every day more heavy, more busy, with more events coming in, multi-sport events, and that makes more difficult the scheduling. The coach especially, the instrument, one of the most important instruments, they are working outside of every day training program, or weekly program, monthly program. It's the competition calendar. And there are a lot of requirements. What happened? Happened that national federations receive support from different authorities in the respective countries, and these authorities are requesting, and they have criteria how they are delivering the budget. The criteria are based on results on the events. What are your results? And number one, you want or you don't want, it's Olympic Games. After that, it's coming the World Championships. And After that, probably continental, regional, and other multi-games sports. And in, based on this, you are going to receive your budget. Then, is for that reason, it's very important that we have a good coordination. And just to inform you that the Bureau, 2 days ago, has approved a new FINA rule, BL-12, which is International Competition and FINA World Aquatic Calendar. An international competition should refer to any competition organized, I'm not good on this technology, yes, in any competition organized or sanctioned by FINA, any continental or regional organization or any member federation in which FINA recognized federation clubs individual participates. This is the definition, what is an international competition. After that, the legal committee of FINA has made a very good division of competitions in tiers. You have tier number one, which is Olympic Games, FINA World Championships, FINA World Swimming Championships. Tier number two, other FINA World competition like junior, like youth in all the discipline, World Cups, World Leagues, World Series, and other FINA competitions. Tier three, continental and regional competition. Multi-sport games also. And number four, tier four, member federation international competitions. Each event organized and sanctioned by the FINA member federation or by any recognized federation or club. And number, and tier five, other competition in major international importance competition to define. I have to tell you that it's probably sometime not easy for us to negotiate with the multi-sport games, continental games or regional games in order to see what are the best date, because it's very difficult for coaches, it's very difficult for federations to attend all this event. And for that reason, our duty is to create this world calendar, and it's very important that you are aware of all these changes. The next thing, it's all continental regional organization and members seek approval from FINA for any international competition to be organized, sanctioned by them. The application should be received 6 months before with the proposed dates, and in the application should include dates, competition program, doping control organizer, any modification to the FINA rules and requirements. It's very important that all this procedure, we need probably some time, because always you need the time to learn how to go to that, but it's better to coordinate. We have this rule for many years, but not applied very well. For that reason, now the Legal Commission and the Bureau, hearing their proposal, has approved this new bylaw. All competition must comply with FINA eligibility rules. This is very delicate in some areas about the sport nationality. And for that reason, we have a legal department who is looking at anything can happen and to clarify any situation we may have around the world. We are obliged to publish our world calendar in a website, and we are going to do so. When a new application comes for international competition, FINA will compare the dates, because the difficulty is always the dates, how we can schedule, and to determine if the new dates has any conflict with another competition previously approved. If the conflict deems to exist, is not changing. If the conflict deemed to exist by FINA, or any connection can be there, we should consider discipline, geographic, international competition, age group, and then we should be in a contact with the respective applicant to see how we can go further. We are not there to say no. We are there to find solutions and be sure that we apply all this new interpretation of the world calendar with the intention to support, to find solution, and to create a cooperation. applicants and I'd like to check with FINA all the aquatic calendar before you do your application, because you may found already that there can be probably any difficulties. Is the policy of FINA that no international competition or major international important competition, with exception of masters, should be held within 30 days prior to the Tier 1. Tier 1 is the Olympic Games, Tier 1 is the World Championships, and Tier 1 is the FINA World Swimming Championships. There may be some exception, the very, very exception, must be very, very, very well justified, and we have to consider these two. Again, I repeat, we are not there to say no. We are there to coordinate and to create coherent calendar. Any cancellation also, it's important that we are aware about, and we can adapt immediately our calendar to be reported at least 3 months before. Give us some time, because we need time in order to adapt this calendar. Competition program, it's very important, competition program, because competition program is a very good platform to promote our sport, to promote our disciplines. In Tier 3, continental, regional, multidiscipline competition and multi-sport should include as much as possible all aquatic disciplines. Our wish is that all the multi-sport events, when they talk about aquatics, to have their all the discipline, should include, as a minimum we say, what is today the Olympic program. Because in swimming, we have more events in the World Championships than in Olympics, and it happened like that now with the approval of the Congress yesterday, that in synchronized swimming we have to have the mixed duet, that in diving we'll have mixed synchronized diving. Then the program is changing for the World Championships, hopefully as a platform that IOC will say we can improve the program of FINA because provide additional value to the sport. Tier 4 and Tier 5 ask to state in their application the competition program to be adapted for the reason I say before, because you may have in some parts only relays competition, or you can have only sprint competition, or depend in swimming. But in any other discipline, we have to know what is deviation from the program and what is a special program. Doping control, you know that it's yesterday, the Congress has approved the 85 pages of the new FINA doping control rule based on the WADA code, and these are going to be implemented from 1st of January to 15. There are interesting changes you have to look at on. We will have more to work with our doping department. One thing to say is that the sanction now is going to 4 years instead of 2 years, maximum sanction. Of course, there is a but, and then the lawyers come to explain what should not be and argue what should not be 4 years, but this is an important change. The other change in the doping rule, I just mentioned yesterday, but I want to underline today, is the appearance of NADOs. The NADOs now, every day, become more independent, more active, and more competitive. But we have always achieved agreements with some of them, how to coordinate our work. Where is the work of NADO? Where is the jurisdiction of FINA? And I have to tell you that it's a lot of work in this side. Then the Tier 1, 2, and 3 shall help complying with the FINA rules, FINA doping rules, there is no doubt. 4 and 5 may happen that you have, for example, SEA Games, which are regional games, and they can apply their specific doping rules, but these doping rules should be in accordance with FINA and WADA rules. Any application, the problem is who has the jurisdiction. And this is something we want to clarify before. Who has the jurisdiction if there is an adverse analytic result? The next is going to be the modification of FINA rules and requirement. Any application for approval shall indicate if any modification will be. You would like to modify something in the program. You would like to do something different. Please do so. We will check with our technical committees. We will see what is the response. And based on this, we will go further with and continue to find the best solution. Again, I repeat, we are not there to say no. We are there to find solutions, to create a coherent instrument to help all of us to continue growing and to have the success of aquatics. And of course, if you don't complain with this, at the end of the day, something is going to happen, then maybe a sanction in accordance with the FINA rules. It's very essential that we are coordinating, with our own events and that we can work together. It's basic for developing of the sport today. Every day, new events appearing. Beach games, summer games, youth games, any kind of games. Then we should have a very good coordination in our calendar. I am pleased today to unveil the 15-17 FINA World Calendar, made in cooperation with the Continental Federations, Associations, and with the FINA Technical Committee. And also, I'm happy to report that as of today, we have no overlaps or clashes in our calendar. Then the work has been done properly. We don't start from zero, but I'm sure we need to go further. This is the calendar. You are going to receive it. You see 15, 16, 17. Why 17? Because in 17, we are going to hold again the General Congress, and probably the technical congresses, and maybe something there is going to be changed. As you see, the main competition next year, Kazan, and there it's very important. Yesterday at the Congress, Kazan organizing committee make a presentation. For me, I take the opportunity again to rise two issues. First issue, which is very important, is the visa, and please, here, we, for the first time in these championships in Doha, we have utilized the JMS. JMS is General Management System. And through this system, the National Federation can enter their applications, and it's very simple to understand everything about the championships. Through this JMS, you can receive this previous accreditation, which is going to be used as visa. It's very important because everywhere you go, here also in Qatar, having the visa was a great work done by the organizing committee. With some difficulties, here and there, but the visa is an important issue today. And the second issue, for the first time, the World Championships is going to be organized style multi-game sport. We have multidiscipline sport. It's going to organize with the village. And in the village, you have a lot of opportunities. Important opportunities, health support, 24-hour food, restaurants, everything open, any kind of assistance, entertainment, easy transportation to the venue, easy transportation inside. Then this is going to be some unique because Kazan in 13 has organized the Universiade, and for that they created this village. Then we take this opportunity to use. Probably the same thing, I'm not sure, is going to happen in 2019 in Gwangju, Korea, because Korea next year will organize also the Universiade and construct the village. Then we try to give to the athletes as much as possible and to the teams this type of accommodation. We continue with our support. 2,500 athletes, officials who receive travel accommodation, meals free of charge. We continue with all this support. Then you have the World Junior Championships, which become to be stronger and stronger event. The last event in Dubai was very, very successful, unbelievable successful. For that reason, we rise it, and we are going to have television coverage. We are going to have a sponsorship, and we are probably going to have also support to National Federation to attend this event. It's important that you understand that the main issue of FINA is to raise the level of the National Federation. that rise the level of our sport, to be more successful every day. Then you have all other events in 15, then you have the event 16 and 17, I'm not going to mention. Also, you receive the open water, not only swimming. You will have the water polo. You will have the diving. You will have the synchro, the masters. And with diving was also the high diving, because in high diving, the only thing we do for the moment is the World Cup and World Championships. High diving, very successful event, has been organized the World Cup in Kazan this year. Great success, unbelievable television viewers worldwide, and this is very important for us. With other words, the conclusion for me, the next 3 years are very exciting and very busy for us. We will have 2 World Championships, we will have 1 Swimming World Championships, 25 meter, and we will have many other events. To continue the success of Aquatic, it's very important in engaging Florius Sasset. The thing it is that your participation in FINA events, especially because we have swimming coaches here and you are the engine of this discipline, participation in Swimming World Cup, it's a basic for showing to the world that swimming, it's the best sport. It's on the top of international sports. This year, unfortunately, the experience was not the best we can have concerning the participation. We still have, this year we have 7 legs. This next year we'll have 8 or probably 9 legs. We have created the clusters where the swimmer can choose which 3 events they want to go, because we understand that nobody can go to all the events. But we need to show to the world, because all these events, they have television coverage, worldwide coverage, the signal going over 150 territories. Then it's important to show to the world the value of our athletes. For that reason, now what I do, it's an appeal to the federation, coaches, administrators. FINA competition, very important to show to the world that swimming is not local event in some areas or in some continent. It's a worldwide event. Other IFs, they can have 14 legs in order to be more on the screen. If you are not on the screen, you have no value. Then, with other words, only together, all aquatic family, we can make sure that aquatics will continue to develop at all the level, worldwide, and remain what is important, remain the leader of international sport. And this because of your support and because of your fantastic work. Thank you very much.